I call these interviews a butterfly effect interview. You know what is butterfly effect? Butterfly effect is an effect when I got to know first time कि मुझे पहली बार पता चला कि butterfly effect नाम की भी कोई चीज होती है तो मैं तो शॉक में आ गया because butterfly effect means when a butterfly flips its wings उससे जो हवा displace होती है उस हवा का displacement with time the different place of the world it converts as a storm that is a butterfly effect मतलब आपके लाइफ के जो छोटे छोटे काम होते हैं वो छोटे छोटे काम आपकी लाइफ में इतने इंप्रूव हो जाते हैं दैट यू ग्रो अ लॉट इन योर लाइफ हमको मैनेजमेंट में भी ये थ्योरी पढ़ाई गई है इन मैनेजमेंट इट इज कॉल्ड पैरेटो प्रिंसिपल्स इन पैरेटो प्रिंसिपल्स योर 80% रिजल्ट्स इन लाइफ कम्स फ्रॉम 20% थिंग्स एंड आई रियलाइज बुक राइटिंग बिकमिंग एन ऑथर इज सिमिलर situation when you write a book everyone everyone start looking at you differently and it becomes butterfly effect so that's how we bring a lot of authors today I have a special guest with me his name is Nikhil Taide is engineer by profession and has worked in a lot of multinational companies he is his city of residence at the moment is Pune and I think he's from Nagpur. He did his engineering. He's an engineer from Nagpur University, and he loves creative writing and he loves English. So he's doing diploma in creative writing in English, and he has spent last few years in creative writing domain, and always strive to create spark in his writing. I loved when first time I wrote, I heard a book. From author's mouth and I had chills in my entire body the way he writes it's amazing if you're not read his book please read it he believes that each one of us has a story to share and our life is a big story he has done on several creative writing projects but particularly liking towards short stories and novel writing he wrote his book which is called coffee table stories is his first project It is compilation of his stories when he isn't writing, he goes for distance cycling. He is a cyclist. He loves cycling and that's how he lives. So he has done 200 kilometers cycling category. So cycling is his passion. He also likes to travel. When he goes to Nagpur, no, he drives to Nagpur. Nagpur is how many? 12 hours ride, Nikhil, right?
How many? Yeah, close to 14 hours. It's like 750 kilometers. Yeah.
He rides, I think, once a month or twice. Once in every 2 months, he surely goes to Nagpur by, driving his own car. And he loves travel. He loves to explore different people. And as far as I know, Nikhil is a very emotional person. So this is from my side to you. I want Nikhil to share about yourself. Tell all of us, your journey about being a writer, how engineering student turned writer, creative writer is born.
Yeah, okay. So Kailashji, first of all, thanks a lot for the quick introduction about me. By profession, I'm an engineer and now working in a multinational company currently associated with Philips. So I have been associated with quite some MNC companies in the past 12, 13 years. So around 13 years of corporate experience I have. But at the back of the mind, there is one hobby portion that is still there. And which was slightly died off when I was doing engineering and a few years after that, because our priorities are different in different, steps of the life. And this is somewhere I used to write short poems and short stories when I was a kid. And slightly it went off when I did engineering and then started my professional career. Then over a few years, once everything was still in life, I thought we should do something about this particular aspect. Professionally, it's okay, but then the hobby thing also needs to be clicked off at a certain point in time. And that's how when I started off this journey again. I'm saying again because I have a few poems which as a kid I had written way back. I think it is like 20 years ago. It was 2016 to be precise. I was just cleaning my room as a kid. In Nagpur, I have my own room where I have a room. Where I was just cleaning my room, and I found that diary out. And it occurred to me that this is the passion that I should still continue. And that's how creative writing then again came into my life somewhere between 2015 and 2016. So yeah, long story short, an engineer, and then again trying to keep his hobby alive. It's a short story, I would say. Yeah.
Tell us more about your book, which is Coffee Table Stories. So one, it is a very interesting name. So I want you to talk about the name first. Why did you pick this name? And second, I want you to talk about how did you get inspiration to write multiple short stories?
Okay. Yeah. So Kailashji, I am a strong believer that every one of us has a story to tell. In short, I also believe that life itself is a big story. We have different episodes every day. We come across different stories of ourselves, of different people, and these stories are full of emotions, expressions, and a lot of things. Somewhere in this busy world, we have stopped capturing those emotions, or we have stopped giving a thought on those emotions and expressions. So my idea of writing this book was to capture these subtle emotions which we feel but we do not appreciate maybe lately because of the busy life schedules and the fast moving or fast pace of the life. And talking about the title, Kailashji, it so happened that I was just having a coffee with my colleague in one of the coffee breaks in office, and then I was thinking, we were just having some discussion on books. Many of us start the book, but we are not able to finish the book because of the length. And then we have different priorities in time. And, if the book is not very interesting, it's very difficult to finish it. So my idea was, let me put up a collection of short stories. And these are like small stories. If you start one story, it will be finished off in, say, 15, 20 minutes or maximum 30 minutes of time. So my idea was, anybody who is taking a coffee break from his busy schedule, yes, and just pick up one story out of this collection, can finish it off in one day. He can leave that expression and he can lay that emotion in that particular time frame of 15-20 minutes. So the idea behind giving that title, so this idea of having the collection of short stories together.
So can you name your stories, all 10? What are the names you have given, so that everyone can feel at least from the name?
Name of the stories, right?
Name of the stories, yes.
Yes. So the first one, and it is very close to my heart, the first story is called as Lucky Stone. It is basically an emotion which gives a slight connection between life and afterlife. So sometimes we relate death as something that is beyond life, which is not a part of life. But my belief is that it is as much part of life as the life itself is. And Lucky Stone is a story that captures or tries to capture the emotion. So that is first. Second one is, name is Amravati. So Amravati is a small town, or I could say a rural area near my hometown, that is Nagpur. And the story is between the connection of how small town guy, when they go to bigger cities, what are their light and what is their story like? So it is just a generic story that is capturing that emotion. Third one is Love Payment. I will not talk about all, because these two are very special, which are the first ones in the book. Next is Earring. The first one is Are Not For Sale. So this is again a very emotionally sad story. Again, talking about and afterlife. Two movie tickets, Asmish, Worthless, and Road by Even. So these are the stories I've written. And mostly, if you see, it's like the emotions are captured in these 10 stories.
Nikhil, can you switch off the camera? I think we may be able to listen to you well. Was that bandwidth?
Okay. Is it okay now?
Yeah, it's better. So, which one is your favorite one?
Kailashji, my favorite one is the first one, the Stone. So, as I've given a slight, small statement for each of the stories. For Lucky, it is the superpower of a mother to help her child. So it's a story, as I said, it's a story which compares the life and afterlife and death. So that's how it happens to be one of the most favorite.
Yeah, I have used Nikhil's book for, Nikhil is going up and down because of internet, he's at hometown. But to all of you, I use Nikhil's book for reading stories to my son. So I love the way he's written the stories. I mean, The Lucky Stone is my favorite story too. And whenever I get time, I have a story telling session to my son, who is 8-year-old. So I always go and pick up Nikhil's book and show, read the stories for him, because Nikhil's stories are small, quick, emotional, and very connecting. And there is a quick, good learning in the story. So I use this lot. So quickly, you know, while I was sharing everyone, you know, I read your storybook to my son, and he's happy to listen to stories. And this Lucky Stone is a very beautiful story. It is about a small boy who loses her mother. Her mother demise happens, and the father sends the son to the nanny's place, and how he meets a small boy there, and how this small boy teaches him a lot of lessons of life, which ideally her mother guides from the sky to him. It's a beautiful story. You should read it. Manvindra Singh, her favorite story is the last one. What is the last story, Nikhil?
Yeah, so the last story is Road Number 11. And Kailashji, I will tell you something interesting about this story. This is something that has happened actually with me. This story talks about
your life.
Yes. So there was once I was coming alone, like as you had mentioned in my introduction, that I keep on traveling between Pune and Nagpur quite often. So there was one time when I was alone, and there was some trouble in my car, and I was completely alone. There was nobody to help on the road. And there was this guy who out of nowhere came up on his bike or moped, I would say. He was kind of a mechanic. That was exactly the need of the hour. I was looking for somebody who can help me fix my broken car. And he came out of nowhere, fixed it up, and without taking any money or any appreciation, he just left. Wow. And that's exactly the emotion I've tried to capture in this story, because the subtitle also says that God is within us. You know, we spend our entire life looking for God, praying for God, going to temples and searching for God everywhere. But you know, lately I've realized that God is nothing but our own selves. You know, it is just a matter of appreciating the fact that that He is around, and He is just in different form and nature. So yeah, that's it's captured in the last story. Thank you, Manvindra, for
my favorite story. I don't remember the title, but you remember the title is where the father you know, father's last money comes for the flat purchase. What is the story called? When the son want to buy a bike.
Yes, it is the last payment.
The last payment.
Correct, it is the last payment.
Yeah, the last yes. payment. That is my favorite story. And if you have not read Nikhil's book, it's amazing book. Quick reads, every story you may take 20 minutes to read. There is no relation between stories, so you don't have to remember ki pehle story mein kya tha. You can pick up any story and start reading. It's a beautiful book. You should definitely think of reading. And what was the inspiration of writing book now? What happened that you decided to write a book now?
Okay, very interesting question, Kailashji, because I started writing I started rewriting somewhere in 2015 or 2016 time frame. There was quite a lot of blogs I had written between these 4 or 5 years, but nothing was concrete, you know, because writing articles, writing blogs, writing short stories, is good to some extent, but I was not able to take it to the next level. I had a lot of ideas. Maybe I can you know, create a YouTube channel, try to create some vlog in the form of stories, or maybe, you know, create some my own website where I can host some stories there for people to read, but nothing was getting concrete. And that's where then a thought also came that I should go for book publishing, but then that was, you know, there are a lot of ifs and buts into this. Writing a book and becoming a published author is really something as a milestone, I would say, in anybody's life. And that's why it is not very much pursued commonly. And then in 2020, when the pandemic started, you know, the lockdown situation started in India, and I was just surfing net one day, I came across Superfast Authors. I read the webinar content and I was really thrilled because there was this catchy line that I came across that become a published author in 30 days. Yes. And I was wondering that 5 years, I am not able to move a single step. And here is this guy who is claiming that in 30 days you can become a published author. Then I thought, let's go for it. You know, what's the harm in going to the webinar and just listen to it? And then one thing led to another. And then I came across your Bookathon program, which, by the way, is so strong that a lethargic person like me can complete a book in almost like I was not able to do it in 30 days, but I think close to 45 days, I was able to finish it. So yeah, it is so well structured.
Because Nikhil, you know, my program is short 30 day formula for non-fiction book. A lot of people are able to do fiction also, because fiction you need ideas to flow, but there is a structure to ideas to flow in fiction also. But it is amazing you did it in 45 days. It is a dream for a lot of people to write fiction book altogether. You did it for 45 days. It is like big surprise for everyone, and big dedication from your side. It was dedication, pure dedication from your side.
Yes. But indeed, I mean, there is a slight difference between how we pursue the non-fiction and fiction books. That yes. is definitely there. But then the structure at least gives you triggers. Although from non-fiction, it is, you know, non-fiction, you have to just think about the rationale behind writing a chapter or writing a particular question or going across any concept, but fiction needs a certain level of you know, emotional part of it, or maybe, you know, yes. there are some other soft aspects which comes into picture. Yes. But what 30 days formula has really helped me is the community that is created. You know, we are all authors who are connected through this community. We have you know, the partners who are supporting each other, and I came across very you know, very great people in this group who always kept me pushing. And then, although my book was non-fiction, or rather my book was fiction, it was not non-fiction, still I was able to, because of this community, I was able to pursue my dream. So that's really the big advantage there.
It's wonderful, Nikhil. And I am inspired too, the way you have written, and you have written beautiful stories. And I remember, I know that, you know, we discussed that you are writing another story already. So fiction and stories are part of your bloodstream now. That's what I can feel of. And yes. So how was people's reaction? Because, you know, in Bookathon, we always announce the book quite early to everyone on social media that you are writing a book. So how was reaction by people? I want to know positive and negative books. So how was that reaction?
Okay, yeah, very interesting question, Kailashi. So let me first talk about negatives, and then maybe we can talk about positives.
Because the voice is really good, I think, it's a book camera.
So let me try and put the negatives first. And positives, because positives were a lot, negatives were not many. So when I announced this on social media, frankly speaking, I was also not, you know, not aware that I would be able to finish this. But then I took a bold step. I announced it on social media. Then there were mixed reactions, because many people, they were not aware about this aspect of me, that I write book and this is my hobby. So they were like a lot of questions. Like, will you be able to write, or this is something that we never knew, so we are looking forward to it. So there is sometimes a performance pressure, you know, when Sehwag is batting or opening, and there is a big total to achieve, he usually gets out in the first over. This was the normal scenario we used to observe in 90s or early 2000s. So that was the same thing I was going through. And if you remember, I also called you that I'm in a little bit of social pressure now that yes. I've announced, and then you said, no, don't worry, the 30 days is a very structured program, you will be able to do it. So I would not say this is completely negative. It was kind of still motivational, because yes. these comments from different people to help me pursue this really helped. Now, talking about positives, it was a ripple effect, because in today's world, I would say we are so focused on our careers, on professional life, that this hobby part is never pursued by many. I would say by maximum number of people. And if you see anybody who is trying to pursue this, or who at least says that this is my hobby and I'm trying to do something about it, you get a big boost. People like it. And that is what exactly happened with me. People used to compliment me. Many people called me from my previous organizations and previous networks. They called me and they said that, wow, this is good that you are at least trying to do something in the field that is other than your professional path or professional career. So, so these were the positives. This kept me going for the entire journey. And, it's kind of a different situation you are in when you announce it on social media. Yes. And when you actually see the book in hand like this, it's a different story or different journey altogether.
And how was your office, the office you work, how was their reaction when they got to know, Kere, Nikhil is writing a book? So how was that, your boss? Yeah. Oh, and your colleagues there.
Yeah, so one thing is, in my office, very few people know that I write. There is a colleague who just sits next to me. He is only aware about it because I keep on talking to him, and we usually share coffee a lot. So I usually tell him something about my stories. So he was not very surprised. But there is a majority lot of the people in the office who came to know about this first time. And I had some big plans, Kailashji, because I wanted to hand over this book personally to each and every colleague of mine as just a gift from my side. But what happened is, when I announced it on social media and it went on to the booking platform, everybody in my office had already booked a copy of my book. So I did not get the chance to personally hand it over to them. So such was the effect in office. And now I would say, Kailashji, people have a different angle to look at me. Earlier, they used to just look at me from a professional angle. But now they call me as Author Nikhil Daddy. So when I join some meetings or discussions, usually people refer to me as Author Nikhil has joined. So yeah, it's really a good feeling to hear that.
And how is it completing the book? You've been working hard, there's a social pressure, you're writing every day, and there is one day comes in when everything is done. Now everything is given to Kailash and the team, and now they're going to work on it. Superfast Author is going to work on it. So how was that feeling when you saw the last full stop?
Yeah, so a little about the journey, Kailashji. I was very fast in writing the initial stories. There were no hiccups there. And then I was stuck for a particular story. I was just thinking what I should write, the last one particularly. And it took around 2 weeks of time to complete the last step. Because usually, you have already completed 90% of the book. And then for the last 10%, there's always something that you get stuck up at. And then finishing that, and then realizing that your baby is ready to be delivered, is a different feeling. Now I've recently become father, so April I was blessed with a baby girl. So the feeling that I had that day and the feeling that I had when the book actually the last full stop, as you say, when I put, was exactly same, because it is as good as having your own baby getting delivered. So
yes.
Yeah,
an amazing feeling, right? And
out of the world.
What was the aha moments of book writing process? When you were writing the book, you are becoming the author, you're writing so many things, but did you feel certain emotions which you thought, are wow, this is also I'm learning something new? So any aha moment you want to share with us in the process of book writing?
There is one thing I usually people wonder, and I also had also a lot of questions regarding this, how to go about book writing. Because in fiction writing, there is sometimes you realize a plot, sometimes you realize how the story needs to be written, and you actually write it. So these are two different aspects. The plot seems to be very strong, and then when you actually write it, you think that no, it's not that great. Or sometimes it's the other way around. You think that the plot is not so strong, but let me try it. So the time between you realize the plot and you actually write is the game changer. And what happened is, the aha moment, I would say, is in the bookathon, you taught us that, or rather the structure teaches us that you sit and write. you know, because book writing is nothing but sitting and writing. There are many people who have big dreams, big you know, thought process about books, but this is the simple thing that pick up the pen, pick up the paper and start writing. And that is where you connect that plot to the actual writing. And that was the aha moment, frankly speaking, because today also, if I am in the pandemic, if I am free, if I am not doing the office work, there are 10 or 12 different ideas I get about stories, short stories. But there are only one or two that come onto the paper. That's because only I am not able to sit and write dedicatedly. So and that's the aha moment.
I believe in a flow. What you said is, in other words, called a flow. When the flow of thoughts is coming, do not stop that flow. Pick up pen and paper or computer. Just let the flow out on the structured way. That is what I say. Because, you know, flow is God's message. That's what I say. Flow is a word which is used in spirituality a lot. So let the flow flow in so you become an author. Right. So I am very happy with you, like the same. And any other characters you build up in the process of writing, other than being a, you become an author for sure, your book came in, but any other characteristic you built in when you were writing the book?
Very good question, I would say, because there are two things I came to know about myself. Number one is I can be disciplined. That I realized about myself. So this, because usually there are a lot of things I have tried, I've started and then those things stopped. Other than the professional work, because you cannot stop professionally, you have to continue writing. But I am talking about the hobby portion of it. So I am a cyclist, as you said. So I had a dream of writing or riding a Tour de France sometime in my lifetime. Now I have crossed the age. I started very strong, completed 200 kilometers mountaineering, and then I could not continue for some reasons. Gymming, I have health, fitness, or you know, this particular aspect I wanted to do regularly, but every time I start and then I stop somewhere. So, but book writing is something, you know, publishing a book is a milestone. And I was really doubtful when I started this, will I be able to complete this? I started because of the 30 days assurance of the bookathon, but I was not very sure about it. But when I complete now, I realize that I have become more disciplined and I have become more professional in my approach towards the soft aspects, you know, because professionally, you are always professional. Personally, you are not that professional. And this is the new thing that I have discovered within myself. Yeah.
Okay, very good. Fantastic. So anyone can be disciplined. So I want you to tell upcoming authors, a lot of upcoming authors are listening to you right now. Who want to become an author. So any advice you want to give them so they can easily, you know, become an author, any advice you want to give them so that the book writing journey becomes easy for them, because now you have already done it.
Yeah. I think, you know, I've read a book recently that is called as Everything is, sorry for the language, because that's the title of the book by Mark Manson. And there is one very interesting aspect in there. He talks about two brains. We have a thinking brain and we have a feeling brain. And thinking brain is quite logical. You know, it studies the data, it does the analysis, and then it tells you, no, this is not a good thing. Or maybe this is something good. Now, and feeling brain is something that tells you that this is your passion, you should go for it. Don't think about the analytics part of it. Just go and do it. So I would say when it comes to the process of book writing, oftentimes your thinking brain will catch up. You will always say that, oh, I have not written a book before. There are many great authors out there. How can I or how can my book compete with that? These all sorts of questions will come to your mind. So this is your thinking brain, which is in work. So I would say shut it down for a few days or a few months. Focus on your feeling brain, because feeling brain will always tell you, go for it, pursue it. This is your hobby, just do it. So follow your feeling brain for at least a couple of months or a month's time, and you will see tremendous difference. Once you complete that first draft, first manuscript, I can't tell you the happiness of having your dream come true is something different, out of this world. So follow your feeling brain, shut off your thinking brain for at least few days.
And we have a 30-day formula too. Not more than 30. Right. One interesting question I have is, because sometimes when I, you know, speak to people about you should have a coach and mentor in your life, what is the role of coach and mentor to help you write book? सो बुक राइटिंग में कोच और मेंटर का क्या रोल रहता है? हाउ इम्पोर्टेंट दैट पर्सन इज?
I would say it's important as a salt in your food or sugar in your tea, if you have if you don't have diabetes. But see, the point is how good author you are or how good as a person you are. You always need a guiding principle, a guiding arm, or a guiding path to follow. Role of a mentor in book writing will help you not only in technical terms, but also in many very behavioral aspects, or very soft aspects of writing. You'll get for no reason the content, you have the structure. I'm just giving an example why mentor plays a role in life. You might have everything that you need for book writing, but you can still get stuck for a number of reasons. It is these times that the mentor or your guide or your principal will help you out of these difficulties. There are some simple things or small things wherein you are stuck at. You cannot see the obvious, which this mentor can see, because he has gone through that cycle or through that process n number of times. So that's why it is very important. I was of the belief that it is not as important because you are the author, it's your content, it's your material. But that is not the case. You need a guiding hand, you need a guiding principle always. And that has been really the main success story for me as well. If it was not for super fast authors and Kailash's guiding principles, probably I would have been still writing short stories without getting it published on a platform.
And thank you very much, Nikhil, for saying it. I also believe that the role of mentor differentiates between whether you are a published author or not, because a lot of people have ideas, they are writing it, but a small, tiny, tiny thing can stop people to not move ahead in life. And when someone is there to give a call and say, "Okay, I'm stuck here, let me know what to do," and that you'll get your answers. And that power alone needs, everyone needs a mentor. I have my own mentors too, who help me, support me whenever I get stuck. At least most of the time, I know just they are behind me, I don't get stuck. It's a miracle, but it happens.
Right, absolutely.
It's a role of mentor
Yes.
is very important. I want you to give gratitude to people in life who help you in book writing process, or rather in life, how you are and where you are. Who would you like to give gratitude on screen, on live interview?
Yes. So a big thank you, I would say, to start with my family, because they have been an immense support in all this book writing journey, for allowing me to pursue my hobby, because it takes time. You have to dedicatedly allot some time out of the day to these activities. Now, it is not possible without the family support. So number one, first and foremost, my wife, my kid, and also my elder brother, his family, everyone family has a great support for this. Secondly, there are a lot of friends who believed in this, because not many friends knew about this hobby of mine. A few of them who are very close to me knew about this, and they always kept me encouraging. Started rewriting somewhere in 2015, and my family was not aware about it, because these were like small drafts or small short stories I used to write. So it was this circle of close friends who used to read it and then give me the candid feedback that Nikhil, this is going good, or maybe these are a few things that you should improve. So all those people, all these friends, a very small close-knit circle, but they have been an immense support system in my life. A deep gratitude to them. And lastly, my mentors, and including you, Kailashi, and Superfast Authors, really thankful that I came across this platform, that I came across this wonderful book journey, mechanism or structure, I would say. Otherwise, this was not possible. A deep thanks from the bottom of my heart to you guys and to your team.
Thank you very much, Nikhilji. I believe that it is a lot of your efforts you put in. You place your faith and trust. That makes you a different person altogether. And when you place faith in other than you, you ideally increase faith in yourself. That's how the life works. Thank you for faith, trusting us and that increase your own trust on your now I'll open the question answers for audience to ask. If you have any questions to ask Nikhil directly, you can ask anything and he will answer your questions. By the time you are asking the questions, you're typing in, I would like to ask Nikhil, what's after Coffee Table Stories? What's the next plan on your hobbies?
One thing, Kailashi, to answer that, I would like to coffee stories when I wrote this book. And I also discussed this with you quite sometimes that I'm really skeptical how many copies or how many books will be sold. That was one of the that was there in my mind. And I was of the opinion that even if one book gets sold from Amazon or Instamojo, I am with that effort. Everything is good about it. This is already there and a lot of people have appreciated. I've got very good comments about my book. I'm definitely going to pursue my hobby of creative writing to the next extent. I'm also exploring a few different domains like poetry and also prose writing. So these are the next hobby lined up, I would say.
Yeah, you have a question from Manvinder. She's asking, when is the next project coming?
Yeah.
Tentative date, you want to comment?
Okay. So, very interesting one. Not very sure at this moment because a lot of things are going on, but very soon. Might be maybe in next couple of months, I'm definitely planning to have my next project lined up.
Wonderful. So, if you have any other questions, you can ask the questions from Nikhil. And Nikhil, can you tell a little bit about a second book? Is it fiction? Not much of it. Keep the curtains off because, surprise is always good. Everything should not be disclosed. But little bit, it will be fiction, non-fiction, poetry. It will be short stories or a long story. Can you share a little more data about your second book?
So Kelly, it is in the field create right. So I will plan for fiction book the second also, and this time I'm slightly taking a different approach. This will be a collection of stories, but maybe a bundle of some long stories. So I'm slightly moving out from the genre of short story writing, and at the same time I'm also exploring a non-fiction book, which is slightly linked with my professional angle. So that is also one of the book I'm planning. This will come in phase. I'm right in the flow of fiction. I said I'll go with and then maybe. Sorry?
Yeah, I think we discussed once the book on project management also, I remember.
Exactly, yes. The book on project management is the one that I'm planning, the next one. But it is off cards until 2021. This year, I'm still focusing more on creative writing.
So, it's wonderful reading your stories. I am definitely going to take it up to read your next book for sure. I read your first one also and I want to read the second one also. My son loves you a lot, Nikhil. He loves the way you write your stories and he's fascinated whenever I speak, and he met you also when I came to see you for one of our discussions. So, he knows you now, and your book is in our house. So Rahul is asking the question, Nikhil.
I'm so glad.
So Rahul is asking, since when in your life you thought of writing a book?
Frankly, speaking Rahul, I write since 2015 or 2016, but writing a book thought really came up in 2020. The beginning of this year, I was really seriously thinking about, publishing whatever work that I've written so far in the last 4 or 5 years, or at least taking up it to a professional angle. That was really something started early 2020. It's when I came across and could post that.
Okay, it's wonderful question, Rahul. He's been writing from wrong, but thinking of converting that writing in a book was gift of 2020. A lot of good authors in our community have got a wonderful year called 2020. It was a year when we have best memories of our life, and COVID could not spoil us. It helped us grow. So thank you for
exactly my point.
So with this, we would like to end this interview.
So yeah, it's something that is
Yes, Nikhil.
Kailash, I was just saying that something that bad is happening around, you know, it's pandemic and we are in a state of a little bit of shock and confusion, but at the same time, you know, there are things that we can see the positive aspect of it. There is always a ray of hope in all the negatives, and that's where I think we made the most out of what situation we have got. So I'm really glad that I could do this, and maybe everybody can do it, because it's just following your heart and following the structure, I would say.
So I want to add up on what Nikhil said right now is, Nikhil ki to paancho ungliyan ghee mein hai, because the company he works is also in medical devices, and COVID has grown a lot of pharmaceutical companies and medical device companies. So his company also did well in COVID, being in the right domain as per situation. इसलिए निखिल की तो पांचों इंग्लिश घी में है अभी, प्रोफेशनल पर्सनल, एंड ही गॉट ब्लेस्ड विद अ बेबी गर्ल इन द हाउस, सब कुछ अच्छा ही अच्छा है. इट्स ट्रू, 2020 इज अ वेरी गुड ईयर फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस एंड श्योरली फॉर निखिल.
थैंक यू सो मच कैलाश जी, थैंक यू फॉर द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स.
सो विद दिस आई वुड लाइक टू एंड द इंटरव्यू हियर, एंड आई वुड हैव कपल ऑफ थैंक्स from my side. First of all, I would like to thank all of you who have attended this interview live. You heard Nikhil about his stories, about the book. You asked him questions, and thank you very much for joining me and Nikhil here on the discussion on book writing. And we both, sense a lot of good wishes, and we always say God bless you all. You grow a lot in your life. Second, I would like to thank a big gratitude to Nikhil. Nikhil, giving us time from your schedule. I know you are in Nagpur. There is an internet connection. There was a demise in the family which kept you engaged for a lot of family and emotions in the house. But still, you somehow got the time for all of us to spend, give answers to us. So thank you very much, Nikhil, for spending your important time of your life with us, because time is another commodity, or I would say time is the most important commodity we have with us, which is never ever replaceable. Money can be replaced, time can never be replaced. So thank you all of you, specifically Nikhil, for giving us time and speaking about you, your journey, your book, your stories as well.
Thank you so much, Kailash ji, and thank you for inviting me. It's really a pleasure to talk to you and also to everybody. I'm glad that I was able to answer the questions and also somewhere be an inspiration to others in helping in their journey of book writing. So thank you very much.
So thank you everyone, and see you soon again. And Nikhil, one request from my side, I want you to voice record your stories.
Okay, yes.
And whenever you get time, voice record your stories without telling us the end of the story.
Oh,
give us the teasers of your different stories. I can open the book and finish the story there. Yeah. But if you do not have a book, we'll have to go for your book, and or they have to talk to you. But I would like to, because I remember first time when I heard story from your mouth was amazing. The way you narrate the stories are another important or rather very special gift you have. So you should use that gift with your stories.
Thank you so much, Kailash. That is really a great idea, because I never thought about it, but it is really a great idea. Let me try it out.
Yeah, I will definitely talk to stories and see the results. It will boost a lot of confidence in people about your stories.
Yes.
So thank you very much, everyone. And we are soon getting video from Nikhil on his stories. It will not be full story, but it will be a good stories. It will at least make us more curious. So bye-bye, everyone, and see you soon again. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Bye.